One and two.
We hope you enjoy tonight's Peace Theater Company production.
Shelby, Tammy, and I will triple up. Bed check will be at 11 o'clock. I'll give you your traveling seat.
assignments in the morning. Starting lineup tonight will be as usual. Shelby, I've been working for you to cast this one so you stop passing off to Wilma so much. She's scoring more than her share of points. Pass off to your earlier teammates and let them get their shots in too. That goes for you too, Wilma. Bertie and Jane, you two will sell programs. Try to do a little better than Wilma and Shelby did last night. Butch, you're on latrine duty. And Tammy, you're on laundry. The machines are next to the gym office down the hall. Okay, that's it.
Wait, I'm almost done with my story.
What shall we say?
I'm almost done.
Go ahead, you two. I'll take the turn, Tammy. I don't care, as long as it gets done.
Thanks, Jimmy. Okay, so this guy can hide the latest.
Look, y'all, I got my picture in the paper.
Ooh, let me see.
Wilma, too. See you right there.
Where is that? Oh, it's her.
Yeah, they must have sent somebody down there. Look, there's a big write-up, too. That holiday basketball treat for the whole family. Here in basketball country, fans are used to seeing their favorite game in many shapes and forms. But tonight, at the Tiger Gym, when Cassius Birdwell's Indiana Shooting Stars meet the Northside men's faculty team, fans will be seeing the basketball in a new shape and form indeed.
Ooh.
The Shooting Stars are a septet of girl basketball players who travel 250 days out of the year, planning and often beating men's teams around the country. But don't expect to see the rule book following the Shooting Stars play. These Lady Hoopsters play a brand of basketball that's a mixture of clowning around with their opponents and the audience, razzle-dazzle ball-handling displays, and jokes that'll have you rolling in the aisles.
So anyways, this guy goes to Rumsey, and he's walking around Baghead. And who does he run into? But Bill Williams. And Bill says, well, howdy, friend. My name's Bill Williams. I'm from Dallas, Texas. And I know everybody, and everybody knows me. So the guy says, come on, Bill. You can't know everybody. I bet there's one person you don't know. I bet you don't know the Pope.
Listen to this. Wilma Simmons is the star of the team. This guy obviously knows what he's talking about. With her dead-ass shooting and cool head under pressure, she regularly racks up over 25 points a game. But for straight good looks, Shelby Tanner is the sweetheart of the team. Looks like you got yourself an admirer, Shelsha.
Let me see that.
So anyway, the guy says, I bet you don't know the Pope. And Bill says, look here, I want you to stand right underneath this balcony here and see if I can come out with the Pope himself. Just like I said, my name's Bill Williams. I'm from Dallas, Texas. I know everybody, and everybody knows me.
Look out!
Now what?
Uh-oh.
Listen to this. Included in the Northside High faculty lineup tonight are two former local basketball greats, 6'1" varsity coach Tom Allen and driver's education teacher and former Northside forward Steve DeSpear Harold.
Shelby.
DeSpear, what does that mean?
Oh,
DeSpear, Shelley.
Maybe means he's skinny.
Or tall.
Maybe he's got a pointy head.
Shelley.
Calm down, Tammy, it'll be fine.
Yeah, Tammy, just think of it this way. When you go to dribble between his legs, you won't have to bend over.
Aww.
Shelby. Now, Tammy, look in my eyes. Do I look afraid?
No.
And look at Birdie. How does she look?
Good. Nice.
Does she look afraid?
No.
You know why?
No.
Because Birdie and I have been doing this longer than either of us cares to think about. We know how to handle ourselves, and we know how to handle guys named Spear. We know that it's teamwork that gets the job done, and the things we Shooting Stars do best is play as a team, okay?
Okay.
She's right, Tammy. Yeah, Tammy, even says here, the Shooting Stars can give any men's team a run for their money with solid outside shooting, precise passing, and when all else fails, a secret weapon named Bertha Birdie Dickerson. Every team needs a muscle man and, oh boy.
What?
Nothing.
Come on, what's it say?
It doesn't say anything. Here, Wilma.
Don't give it to me.
Let me see that.
Every team needs a muscle man, and Dickerson fits the bill. She's a real heavyweight who walks, talks, and plays like a man. Damn, thanks a lot, Shelby.
what you did.
No, I'm just seeing because my sister was thinking about coming to the game tonight. Her and her husband live about 50 miles from here, and I don't want them reading that trash in the paper.
I bet they don't even read the paper.
That's great, Bertie. When are they coming?
I don't know. I'm supposed to call them. They got a new baby that I haven't even seen yet. I got him a toy for Christmas and everything. Y'all want to see it?
Sure.
Yeah.
Look. You wind him up, and he clasps his little hands together. They had a baby boy, and I thought it'd be okay. He's not a doll or anything.
Oh, yeah, I used to have one of those when I was little. Oh, God, it's so cute. Can I see it?
You sure it's okay for a boy baby?
Yeah, I bet he really likes it.
I hope so. I didn't know what else to get him.
It's perfect, Bertie. I hope Colin will come here. He'll probably be dying here. Just phone the gym office down, Colin.
I suppose I should.
Isn't this the cutest thing you've ever seen?
I'm hungry. Just hold your horses. Cassius will be back soon with dinner.
I gotta have a Twinkie in my case.
I'll buy it from you.
Okay.
Well, how much do you want for it?
I don't know.
Well, how much was it?
12 cents.
For the whole thing?
Yeah.
It's half a Twinkie or half a pack of Twinkies.
It's one whole Twinkie. I didn't touch you anything.
So it's one whole half a pack of Twinkies.
It's one whole Twinkie.
Half of two Twinkies, right?
Right.
Switch take a nickel?
It'll be 6 cents,
wouldn't it?
Well, yeah, it's not like it's brand new or anything.
That's true.
Hey, Tammy, I'll give you a dime for it.
A dime? Sure. Okay.
Wait a minute.
Sorry, Butch.
Tammy!
Too late. Struck a deal.
Aw, jeez.
Do you want a bite? You want a Butch?
I'll sell it to you.
I'll give you 11 cents.
Cost you quarter.
Forget it.
Fine. You want a bite, Mom?
I don't know. Do I get half of a whole bite or a whole half of a bite?
You can have two halves of a whole bite
of the moist, yellow cake filled with luscious white cream.
Mm. Ah, give me that.
Hey, where's my quarter?
Getting second runner-up in the Miss Arkansas pageant, and I ended up
an Indiana shooting star.
My brother dated a girl once who was up in Miss Memphis, but she didn't get it.
God, it was sickening. A bunch of us drove up to the pageant at Little Rock to see her. You should have seen her prancing around on stage. The only reason she won the swimsuit competition was because she had so much hair, nobody could tell what she looked like underneath. I should have entered. I could do that stuff. My dream is to become a stewardess so I can meet the people's fathers. I would then like to settle down and raise a Christian family while pursuing my ongoing interest in cosmetology. I would then like to work to institute twirling as an Olympic event to promote a better understanding between the peoples of all the world. Thank you, and God bless.
No way. Here's Butch. My dream is to stop hunger in the peoples of the world by providing Twinkies to all the kids. I will not sweat a lot and take a shower.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the award that all these girls have voted on themselves, the Miss Congeniality Award. Now, we all know that during the pageant week, these contestants have gotten to know each other pretty well. We all know that in their hearts, they truly hate each other. And so now, the award for Miss Congeniality goes to the only contestant who did not vote for herself, Miss Tennessee Tammy Lynn Dwyer. Come on here, Tammy, say a few things to the folks at home.
Gosh, I don't know what to say. What should I say, Wilma?
Thanks, somebody.
I'd like to thank my mom and dad for raising me, and for Cassius making me a shooting star, and for Charlene, Shelby, and Wilma, and Butch, Bert, and James being my friends and help me do that all the time. Thank you. Was that okay?
Thanks, Tammy. That was real sweet.
Yeah, that was really nice, Tammy.
I really didn't know what to say.
Shelby really was a beauty queen once, weren't you, Shel?
Yeah, Shelby got voted Miss Conceit in 1961.
It was just a stupid little local beauty contest. I was Miss January at the boat show in my hometown.
A boat show? In Arkansas? The biggest body of water y'all got in Arkansas is a galvanized wash tub.
We got late. Anyway, I didn't win.
The perp queen didn't win. As much as you work on your looks, you should have won for sheer determination. Didn't you even get most improved?
The girl that won that had big cleavage.
That's important.
I didn't like it.
Is that your butt?
Well, I don't like to brag, but you know what they say. The bigger they are,
the more they sweat.
Hey, would your sister say Bertie is coming?
No, they can't come.
Bertie's got cholera.
Cholera?
Yeah, it makes them all pretty, but they can't leave it.
Colic? You sure want colic?
Cholera, colic. Anyway, they can't leave it.
Oh, it's too bad, Bertie. You must be pretty disappointed.
No, it's just that it's Christmas and everything.
I'm gonna take my shower. Tammy, let me borrow your shower, okay?
If not, get in with Ruth.
I always wanted to be tall.
Don't get it wet, okay?
Tammy.
Okay.
player. Name one other girl who's a better player than you.
Charlene, you score more points than anybody. That's just you.
Will won't break my record easy in a few years. No, they were right to pick you, Will.
Thanks, Char. Number 22 goes down in history.
Oh, look! Fruitcake!
I love fruitcake!
Mom makes it every Christmas. Here, Will, we cut it and we celebrate.
Okay, thanks.
No fruitcake.
Why not?
Kansas will be back with dinner soon. We shouldn't be filling up on sweets.
Aw, come on. He won't care. And it looks so good.
It's okay. We'll celebrate when he gets here.
Oh, it is good. It's not the cakey kind of fruitcake. It's the moist kind. Some people like the cakey kind of fruitcake, but my daddy doesn't. It's too dry. We like the moist kind.
Butter?
My little brother, he doesn't like fruitcake at all. He says he won't eat food that's blue, purple, or green, even if he gives me fruitcake. He hates nuts. He always gives me all the nuts, other cookies, and brownies. So eating you like cookie corn, he doesn't get out to eat all the nuts.
Girl the best. I'm sure she'll try, Shelby, but I don't think it'll do any good.
Kansas, I don't know what to do. I don't want anybody thinking that I'm better than everybody else.
It's a shame, isn't it? Can't think of any way around it, though.
I suppose I could turn it down.
No!
Wilma, you are too much. Have you ever heard of anything so generously sweet? I just love you and admire you so much for offering to do that. Have you ever heard of anything so righteous? This has to be one of the proudest moments of my life.
What?
I'm overcome. Girls, there is a sacrifice that is being made here for each and every one of you today. Now, Wilma, you tell me. Would you like me to write the letter? Would you like to do it yourself? Personally, I think it would be better if it come from you. Tell you what, we could do it together. I'll help you write it, and you can sign your name to it.
Oh, I don't know.
Or you can do it yourself if you'd rather.
Excuse me.
Wilma, sit down, Tanner.
I hope you're all impressed by what Wilma's fixing to do here.
I really wish she wouldn't.
Oh no, don't take that away from her. She's a hero, that's what she is. We can all be proud and learn something. So here's to Wilma. Come on, let's see some smiles here. We won't talk anymore about it. We'll keep it a secret just like Wilma wants it to be. Alright, let's finish up dinner and clear it away. Tammy?
I'm not so hungry right now. I'll finish it.
Just leave it, Butch. Tammy can finish it later. Let's just clean up here. Come on, hop up. I want to work on some plates while we still have some time. Come on, let's go. It's time to get back to work.
Cassius, I
want
to go talk to Mama.
Leave her be. I'd imagine she'd like to be alone right now.
I just want to make sure she's all right.
Shelby, Mama has just possibly saved this team from a blow that might have destroyed her. She was smart enough to realize that jealousy and envy can destroy the spirit of teamwork that holds this basketball institution together. She may have just saved you from yourself. I don't think she needs you to babysitter right now, okay? All right, let's get back to work here. Jane and Butch, front and center. Alright, I think there's been a lull in our comedy after you do the bunny hop out of bounds play before you do the on the shoulders dunk shot. So I came up with a couple of new plays that I think will work. Alright, Butch, just came across midcourt. Wait back like you're waiting for a play to set up. Everybody else, go down around the lane. Alright, so you're dribbling the ball. Let your man come up on you a little bit. You can taunt him a little bit. Then I want you to pull up. Lie on your shoulders, square low in the basket, and look over him like you're going to take a shot. This is going to get him all excited. Jane, that'll be your signal. You give your man a fake. Birdie will set the screen. He'll come around Butch's man quickly, quietly. And while he's waving his arms in the air, I want you to pull his pants down. What's the matter? It's going to be hilarious. Don't pull him down too far. We don't want to get arrested. All right? I think we'll catch him. And when he goes to catch his britches, I want you to drive him around from the lip and pass off to Shelby before the shot. Girls think you can do this?
Sure.
All right, why don't you go through it a couple times and you think you got it, and you bring it in. Shelby, can you see that bag over here? And this next bag is going to be a good one for Tammy. All right, sometime near the end of the first half, I want you to call a timeout. Everyone's going to come over to the bench for a huddle. And I want you to stay closer out to the floor so everyone can see what you're doing. Everyone knows how sweaty Butch gets during the game, right? Alright, well, I want you to start to notice. Stand in the air, hold your nose, make faces or whatever. Butch will start to get real aggravated. Tammy, then I want you to come over to the bench, grab this. Wow, Butch is looking off. Another direction.
I know.
No, Tammy, no. I want you to hit her with it.
Hard.
Hey, Jay.
What?
I'm sorry.
Mama, we were just going over a new gag. Tammy got a little carried away. Put it away now, Tammy.
Kansas, I need to talk to you.
I know you do, and we'll talk later. Right now, I have some business to take care of. I have to go around town and hang up posters. We don't sell tickets. We don't have a team, right? You and I will discuss what we need to discuss later on. You can count on it. While I'm gone, I want everyone to get their hair done. And I don't want anyone bothering Wilma about our previous discussion. That's just over with now, okay? All right, bye-bye, girls.
Please say, don't scream!
Ah!
Y'all?
What's the name?
Great!
You are so long!
Zacchaeus strikes again.
Hey.
Just like him to stand in the land too long.
Watch your mouth.
He's just an old...
Tanner, you're looking at a $10 fine. Now sit down and shut up.
You can't make me shut up. He's wrong and you know it.
Shelby, don't. Maybe he's right. I did sign a contract.
He's just jealous because no one ever wanted to marry him.
Make it 20.
Thank you.
Maybe it's the beard.
Oh, yeah. You little elves wouldn't mind if Santa took off his beard, would you?
No.
Why, sure. What are you wishing for Christmas, little girl?
A better jump shot.
Ho, ho, ho! Just the right answer. You're a good little girl. Now get up, sweetie. You're getting heavy. It's hot in here. The suit is hot. Why is it that Shelby's the only one who has her hair done? Then I told everyone to get that taken care of.
But we got plenty of time, Kansas.
You aren't citizen, are you?
No, of course not.
All right. Go ahead. Clear away the presents. I gotta get some fresh air. You know what? On second thought, I'll be way outside. I gotta use the facility. Come on, get rid of those long faces. I love you, girls.
I love my bath ball, Santa.
And I love you.
So it's all over.
like him.
Why, Cassius?
Charlene, did JD say anything about making the arrangements?
He said he was going to try to catch a bus tonight, get here sometime tomorrow. I'm supposed to wait for him here, but he said to tell y'all to go ahead and go on home.
I knew it.
He said to have to gather the equipment and put it in the DeSoto, and he'll drive Cassius back to Boonville in it.
In the station wagon?
Tammy.
Honey, JD's going to take Cassius back to Indiana.
In the station wagon?
Uh-huh.
Sitting up?
Why don't you both go? okay, y'all, everybody go home.
So what are you gonna say?
I don't know, something dignified.
Like what?
Like, ladies and gentlemen,
that's dignified.
We regret to tell you that the owner of the Indiana Shooting Stars, Mr. Cassius Birdwell, is...
Somebody better write this down.
Is passed away.
Is passed away?
Is what, dead?
No.
Deceased?
Was deceased a few hours ago.
No.
What was the first part again? Ladies and gentlemen.
I got that.
We regret to tell you that the owner of the Indiana Shooting Stars,
Mr. Cassius
Birdwell, is...
Was struck down by a heart attack.
That's good.
This evening.
This afternoon.
Whatever.
And because of this death.
Because of this death.
That sounds stupid.
Because of this event.
Because of this something.
Because of this inconvenience?
No!
How about as a result?
As a result.
What?
Wait, what are we trying to say?
As a result, tonight's game is canceled.
I think we should say that he died.
We already did.
No, we didn't.
You said...
I said he was struck down by a heart attack. I was trying to get around to saying that he passed away.
Jane, what do we have so far?
I don't care. I just thought you wanted to do this whole tribute thing.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to tell you the owner of
the... Okay, now the whole band is here. About 100 more people, and the other team is warming up.
Oh, great! Great.
We beat them.
They're
and Life magazine will take our pictures, and we'll be able to play basketball every single day.
Yeah!
Maybe it's not such a bad idea.
You really think we could be in Life magazine?
Why not?
My parents get Life magazine!
Yeah.
Just
for sure. I mean, now that the word comes out, it looks like it might get better. I mean, I like the idea about being famous and going to France and playing professional ball. What the heck do I want to drag old Raymond around for?
Old Raymond?
Will you marry him?
I'm not going to marry him. Why will you marry him?
I'm not going to marry him. I'm going to catch me a Frenchie.
Well, looks like we're back where we started.
Yeah, we're doomed.
Both sides invited, we got to.
Looks to me like we'll all be home for Christmas.
Jeez, Butch, you think that's a good idea?
Why'd you tell me you quit?
So what?
Hey, Butch, come on, we got a game to play.
So? Look, everybody, the greatest thing. What in the hell? Looks like you're up to your old tricks again, Butch. Put them away. Now! Why should I? Because I said so.
No!
I'm warning you.
Go ahead! What are you gonna do? You got nobody to go tail to now.
I'm still in charge and I'm telling you to put them away.
And I'm still tougher than you are and I'm telling you no!
Butch, maybe I ought to put them away.
Give them to me.
Charlene, I'm gonna smoke this cigarette and there's nothing you can do about it. I smoke. Are you through?
Yes. Fine, Butch. I was planning on putting you in the starting lineup tonight, but now you're permanently on the bench.
No, we need Butch. You can't even get him out.
Too bad.
Hang on a second, Charlene. Who elected you queen for the day? I say Butch plays.
Me too.
As a matter of fact, I got my own ideas for the starting lineup. Maybe you ought to be the one warming the bench.
Yeah.
I'll be coaching and playing.
Says who?
Don't be stupid. Somebody's got to run this team.
I'm not so sure there's anything left to be run.
Look, Charlene, we all decided we're not playing the old way anymore.
Are you still on that kick?
That's right. Just like I said.
Are you all really going along with her on this?
We just want to give it a try. But we want you to play with us.
Don't be mad. It'll be fun. We'll beat them. Damn, you'll see.
Bertie, are you going along with this, too?
Well, yeah.
I can't believe this.
Believe it.
I think I got something here that might change your minds.
Our mind's already made up.
Come here, Bertie. You too. Tammy, Jane.
Wow.
What is it?
Money.
It's all in 20s.
$300. Let me see.
Where'd you get it from? From the promoter. It's our guarantee for the game tonight. He wanted to give it to Cassius, but I told him that I was running things now.
And he just gave it to you?
He didn't want to, but I did some pretty fast talking and told him that if he didn't give me the money, we wouldn't play.
Can I see?
Sure.
You mean this is how much money we make every night? It's so much.
This is how much Cassius made every night.
I never dreamed he made so much.
Me neither.
Can we keep it?
I'll keep it for us. I could keep the team going on this. This will buy bus tickets and food and motel rooms. Then we can have more money every night.
Yeah, but doesn't JD own the team and the money?
He owns the car and the equipment and the uniforms, but he doesn't own us. I could cut him in for a couple hundred until I pay him off. I've got it all planned out.
And do your big plans include telling us what to do and how to play?
Shelby, I know what I'm doing.
That money's not yours. We all earned it by playing for it.
You'll all get paid same as always. And once I pay off JD, you'll all get a bigger share.
That's not what I mean, Charlene. That money isn't yours. It's all of ours.
We all get to decide what to do with it and how we're going to play.
That does seem fair.
Yeah, Charlene. We still want to play with you more.
Yeah.
She wouldn't even have this money if it weren't for me. Don't you see that? I'm the one who got it. You need someone to run the team for you. You need me.
We don't need you. You won't listen to us. So come on, Charlene, hand it over.
No, I won't give it to you.
Hand it over.
No.
Fine. Give it to Bertie. She'll hold on to it till the end of the game. Then we all can decide what to do with it. Go ahead, Bertie, take it. Put it in your locker. You can be treasurer.
Sure, it's nothing personal.
Heck no, Charlene. This will work out great now. We got money now. We got great food with player now. It's all turned out perfect.
Count me out.
Oh, don't say that. Charlene, don't.
Charlene, why are you so dead set against the idea? Don't you even think it's worth a try?
Leave her alone, Butch. If she doesn't want to play, I'm sure she has her reasons. Maybe she's afraid.
Don't give me that.
Oh, come off it, Charlene. It's no secret you've been slowing down the past 2 years. I think your knee is bothering you a lot more than you'd like to admit. You know it's liable to get rough out there, playing with a bunch of men, going head-to-head, under the boards, fast breaking up and down the court. I think you're afraid. Come on, Charlene, give it a shot. Prove me wrong.
Char, you can stay and coach. I mean, we need a coach, don't we, girls? And you can play a little, too, if you want it.
How can she coach us if she doesn't believe in what we're doing?
She'll come well. What's it, Charlene? We need you. You can't be now. We need you. Don't you want to be with us? We need you to be our coach.
I don't think we should hold Charlene here against her will. She wants to go, Tammy. I think we should let her.
Oh, my gosh!
That's started!
Where are the uniforms?
Right here.
Tate.
Butch.
Yeah.